Okay, da. Hey guys, hope you're all well. Just a quick disclaimer before this video starts. It is a bit different to my regular videos, just as my good friend and the owner of this car said that he didn't want to be on the camera or any of the shots. So the video will be comprised of outside shots of the car and looking through the windscreen. There will be, B-roll and whatnot in between them, but obviously you won't see me or the driver during this video. Either way, please enjoy, and I'll see you guys soon. Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. Welcome back to Powered by Petrol. Here's a car powered by petrol. It's a brand new 78 Polo. It's not brand new, it's a year old.
I got it brand new though.
The fair play, you did. It's the 1 litre petrol engine, so inline three. It's got about 95 horsepower.
This shit, that's fine.
It comes with a manual gearbox as standard. Obviously you can options DSG, but that's obviously more expensive. So being the smallest engine Polo you can get, it does come with some fake exhaust tips, as you see at the bottom. It just comes with a plastic trim.
Carbon fibre, I don't know what you're talking about.
Yeah, definitely carbon fibre, like fiberglass. It comes with the small wheels as standard, so these are 15 inch alloys. They come with 185, 65 wheels, tyres, sorry. Obviously fitting around the 15 inch alloys.
The wheels are actually quite nice though, because they're like diamond cut ones.
They are diamond cut. They're like small versions of the GTI Club Sports.
Yeah.
Which is it's a nice little touch, that's what it is. This is the 5-door configuration, of course. You can get a 3-door, which is smaller and a bit cheaper, but I think this is more helpful for families or people with a lot of friends, unlike you. So, how long have you had this car for?
So it's the 3rd of September. I was going to get it on the 1st, but there was roadworks outside the VW garage, so I couldn't get it.
Oh,
so I was 3 days behind when the 78 came.
So yeah, this car is a 78. So buying your brand new car, what's the service like? And how do they treat you?
I haven't been there for a service or anything, but like when I was there, they were alright. They were just asking me loads of questions. But I wanted to get it from the Bridgeford one, but I ended up getting it from Listers.
Yeah, it's all Liverpool, Loughborough, yeah, not too far away.
It's a bit ridiculous. I mean, like, when I didn't want like some servicing package for like 10 years or some shit, they're like, oh, why not? Can I ask why not? And they're like, oh, do you want this cleaning service? And I was like, no, I'll clean it myself. And they're like, oh, can I ask you why not? And I'm like, shut up. Because I know, like, all right,
yeah,
you know what I mean? And you just kept asking me so many fucking questions. Like, oh, why do you want this? Why do you want this? Why do you want this? And I'm like, I don't care.
So this is a brand new car, but it was last year.
Yeah.
The insurance, how was your insurance on this car?
1,000
Okay. So this is Jack's first car.
Yeah, yeah.
This is a very low insurance group. But the newer cars have higher NCAP ratings, radars, assists, all of that stuff. So your insurance gets cheaper the newer the car. So this is insurance. So you've had this car for about 6 months now, 7 months, 6 months?
Yeah.
So how was it getting used to the car?
It was dead easy, really easy to drive. When I first learned to drive, I was learning to drive with my dad's Audi.
Yeah.
Like, that was a bitch to drive. I stalled that so many times. But it's like really good, isn't it? Because if you stall as well, you don't have to restart the car, you just clutch back
in. Push right down. Speaking of systems, are there any like assist packages you've got in this car?
I'll try and run her over. I'll show you. It automatically brakes if like, okay, someone steps out of the car.
Yeah.
And like, I nearly reversed into a tree once. And it stopped. And it stopped.
You've got your parking assist in here.
Yeah.
Auto start stop.
Yeah.
That's
yeah,
in here. Yeah. Saving petrol. It's a small economical car. It's yeah, really good at saving petrol. So this being your first car, and you've had plenty of time to get used to it, are there any things that you don't like about the car?
Yes. There's like, you know, the Apple CarPlay.
Yeah.
When you connect it, sometimes, you know how like it tries to take you home automatically?
Yeah.
How
drive a lot around the motorway.
Yeah.
How about in the city? How's it on fuel? How's its drive control?
Yeah, even worse. It's all right, like controlling it and all that shit is all right, but
yeah,
it's really bad on petrol around town.
Yeah.
For some reason. For what car it is.
Yeah, it is a small engine. Yeah. The what's called 1 litre.
Yeah. Is that turbo though?
It is turbo.
It's not got a lot of power. It's not very light.
Well, no, it's a small car, but the thing is, with these newer cars, the more technology you put in there, and the different things you put into the car, it does make it heavier. And compared to, let's say, a Mark 1 Polo or a Mark 2 Polo,
yeah,
they're so much heavier. These are like Golfs these days, in the size they are, the weight they are.
So, yeah, it's pretty big inside, isn't it?
Yeah.
But there's a lot of room in the back.
Yeah, speaking of room in the back. Speaking of room in the back, have you had passengers in the back before?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's funny. I had like 4 people in it once. And to be fair, it still did manage to do 124 on the way to IKEA, miles an hour.
Jesus.
With 4 people in it, in fourth gear.
Sweet.
So it's alright. It feels nice in there, you know what I mean?
Yeah, the materials are pretty plush, yeah. They're quite nice. So there are these aluminium inserts on the door handles, and there's a kind of plastic trim that goes around the front of the car.
It's alright.
So that wraps around the digital display. So how about the practicality of the car?
Yeah, big boot. So you need to know.
Right, fair play. Yeah,
big boot.
We mentioned the glove box, that's massive. So you fit a lot of stuff in there.
Right, should I go straight on?
Yeah, go straight on.
Yeah, big boot. Seats are nice and comfy.
Yeah, seats are comfy. Yeah. I'm talking about like storage and stuff. So the boot's pretty big.
Yeah, door bin's pretty big.
Yep, door bins, you fit water bottles everywhere.
Yeah.
I think in the rear as well.
Yeah.
Yep.
Beach Johnson.
What's going on there? So you spoke about the speakers, obviously that comes through the Apple CarPlay system. So tell me, how was it to go through all the systems and the infotainment system?
It's alright.
Right,
once you connect Apple CarPlay,
yeah,
it's just like using your phone.
Okay.
Yeah, and you can message. So I get a message and it read it out to me like through Siri.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah,
nice.
And you can reply through Siri as well. So you can like speak into it.
Yeah.
And speak a message what you want to send to whoever.
Okay.
That's pretty cool. But yeah, it's dead easy to use. And like obviously like, all the buttons are there for whatever you need for the actual.
Yeah, so it does have these kind of touch sensitive buttons. So you don't actually press into them, but you just kind of tap your finger.
There's a, if you go into a car, it like shows you like your performance and all of that.
Yeah, isn't
that's
really
that's pretty cool. It shows your economy and shit.
Oh yeah, as a
that's all right. Like your blue score.
Yeah.
So like how like efficiently you're driving.
That's
all right. So didn't come with sat nav like built into the car, so I have to like use Apple CarPlay for that.
Yeah.
Which is a bit annoying.
So someone's about to buy this car. Obviously it's a really popular first car. Polo, they're cheap, good on insurance, they're safe cars. Is there anything you'd let them know before they buy it as a warning or as a kind of a
the noise?
Yeah.
Honestly, like I'm not exaggerating, it's the most annoying thing I've ever heard in my life.
So what he means is, just coming off the biting point, the car kind of sounds like it's struggling sometimes just to move away.
You probably hear it in the video. But like when you're below 2,000 RPM in any gear, it's true.
So these Polos do compete with the Audi A1s, you know, some 1 series, smaller ones, some A-classes,
yeah,
all the smaller, cheapest options from each brand. They're obviously built for your first car. And speaking of Audi A1s, you can see the Audi A1 review I did with Josh in the top right corner there. So click on that and you can have a perspective of both sides. And also check out the rest of the series as well for first time drives. Obviously it's built for people with first time cars.
I feel like there's just better cars out there.
Yeah. So as we mentioned before, this car is designed to be the perfect daily.
Yeah.
But as Jack's saying now, an actual owner of a Polo,
yeah,
you wouldn't buy it.
Yeah.
Or you wouldn't recommend it at least.
Yeah. It's nice to have like a screen and everything. And it is a nice car. But I just feel if you're gonna get a new one, something new, I'd rather spend the extra money and get
Yeah. And speaking of money, this car is expensive. These cars come off the lot brand new at £17,000.
and
yeah, that's pretty expensive
for the amount of money. I mean, I personally, I wouldn't spend 17 grand on anything Volkswagen, because there's just so many other cars out there you can buy for that much money.
You can get the new shape A class.
You know, it doesn't
like mean an 18 plate.
It doesn't mean much about new. You can get an older car, better car,
a new shape,
and just pay for insurance.
Not a new
A-class. Yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah. I mean, you could buy way better cars for £70,000. Obviously, there's different leases and financing stuff you can do to it, and part exchanges. That's all up to you. But I know, personally, I wouldn't spend that much amount of money on a car like this.
Yeah.
It's a great first car, but
I like it though.
You wouldn't want to spend that much money on the first car.
Overall, there's more positives than negatives there.
Yeah, it's a good first car. That's what you can say.
It's good like this. It is quite good.
It's smooth and awesome.
Yeah. And it's like the screen and everything. And it's well built.
Yeah.
That's one thing as well, yeah. Like, it's all like, there's no, it's all like, built very well.
Yeah, it's all solid. There's no like creaks or
eats
or whatever.
Shit, it's all like if you touch it, like, it feels solid.
Yeah.
It doesn't feel like shaking around, shaky. And
it feels £70,000.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't say it's worth it.
Yeah, that's a good point.
So a bit of a shallow note, but we'll end the video there. Thank you very much, Jack, for letting us review your car. I think I had shots of it.
Thank you.
And sorry about the petrol. I know you complained about that.
Love you, Jeff.
All right, any further?
No, man.
Right, thank you very much for watching, guys. We'll catch you up in the next video. Check out the rest of the series. Obviously, weekly videos are coming out. There's a lot more content coming out on the Golf. I've got a bunch of new parts coming and very exciting. So stay tuned for
that
part.
From all
of them. Yeah. So thank you very much for watching. I'll see you all soon.
Bye.